Okay, did this game ever have Zoom? Because this Zoom is real good. Mako with Zoom equals really don't have to worry about the danger, do you? Really don't. This is the real Dark Souls game, yes. I was trying to shoot. Oh, I can't shoot him. I'd love to see how the Geth rationalized me taking my Mako and shoving it right up their Yoo-hoo. I go on a limb here and say, I don't think they notice the difference. Also, this looks great, by the way. So I could have remembered going to this, going to Vermeier. Are we here too early? Because I can't remember. There was like something, like going here was a bad idea too early. Like you didn't want to do. Does anyone remember what that was? Vermeier opens after you finish two of the three planets. Okay, so we finished two of the three planets. I'm just making sure, like, I'm not somewhere where I'm not supposed to be. Because, boy, kind of feels like I am. Thing is, if you go too early, the Paragon Renegade isn't high enough. Bye-bye, Rex? No! You can't kill my baby! Oh my god, wait it. High enough. Or get his family armor. Wait, how do I get his family armor? Because he doesn't really want to talk to us. I mean, I can kind of understand it. Also, this is so broken. I love it. I've only talked to him like 4 or 5 times, I think, and I mean, he says he likes my sass. That could be anything. How do I exit out again? There we go. It's not spacebar. There we go. Yeah, he's been in the party the whole time. The entire time. F5. We have a sexy Spectre sniper rifle for when you need that extra care. TLC from long range. I do gotta admit, Vermeier looks pretty damn good. Wait, did I, okay, I have a really strong sniper rifle. And as far as I can tell, that don't mean jack shit. Okay. Get down there, get it. That's a Krogan for you right there, chat. That's what a Krogan does. Badasses. Mm-hmm. I wondered, We've been having him all on every single mission. I'm hoping, really, really hoping that we don't lose Rex here. That would, oh, that would suck. And look, did that look like it was cheesy? That was a little cheesy. I can't help it. Also, I love how they're still physically there. I don't think we have reach. That's so sad. There we go. Oh my god. Ah! Eject! Oh! There we go. Panicked. how do I repair it? There we go. Okay, so the little guys actually do a lot of damage. Oh, they do quite a bit of damage. And that's the, yeah, that's, oh, that is the little ones. All right. F5, but can you not save while in the vehicle? Yep. Oh god. Woo! Oh, that didn't work. Look, I thought I could pull a Sifu and raise the leg, okay? Cannot raise the leg, chat. Do not try it. It will not work. Okay. 1,000 points of damage. Let's reduce the charge on that. Garrus. I want, yes. Yes. Advanced immunity. And then master immunity reduces health damage by 90%. Does not reduce damage to shields. Well, that don't matter. 90% damage. Dude. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna, because I feel like Garrus is actually gonna want this, and then we'll put some growl rounds in there, some incendiary rounds, and lovely level 6 detection. Really, if I'm honest, detection doesn't seem worth anything. I might be wrong. Shitty shits. Yep. I always get jammed. What's the point of detection if you always get jammed? It don't seem to matter much. I'm just gonna back this up. Yep. You can't take me out with your balls. Hey. Oh, whoa. Did not take any damage there. Okay, not too sure where you're... You can! Woo! You can do it! You can do it, chat! You can loot the leg! I mean, the Mako, but you know, you get the idea. Impressive. Also, I do appreciate that the game just goes, okay, you're in the Mako. We're... just gonna acknowledge that's the same experience point, right? Like, whether you're in the Mako, whether you're on ground, doesn't matter. It's still the same experience. We're not gonna try to, like, kind of remove that. We're not gonna screw you out of the experience. What they need is, like, upgrades for the Mako. Better boosters, better jump jets.
There's our target, Commander.
There was only one sniper here, though, Garrus. Where's the rest? Oh, there they are. I had a friends. Just the three of you? Oh, there's more than you. All right. Light them up. Knock them down, chat. Go say hello. Oh. Woo! A little salt on that. Hmm. Kadoosh. Okay, we might have to, like, if Andromeda has really good ragdoll physics, we might have to, ouchie, ouch. I'm sorry, are you still alive? Yes. We, might have to try biotic. I was hearing, it's like mixed reports. No, we're not. He's right there, damn it.
Destination locked.
I heard the biotic powers are really good.
Clear.
I'm wondering though, just like how good are the
warm up.
Companion characters in Andromeda though. Watch Burke play a little bit, Co play a little bit. Combat looked really good. Okay, this is not a shooty shooty bang bang.
I'm reading that the grid is down, Commander. On approach to the Solarian base now. Out.
Ready to continue. On your mark, Commander Shepard.
Wait for it. Yes. Get all. All right, Rex.
On me.
I think I got enough Renegade to talk you out of doing something stupid. I don't know what that stupid is yet. And I can't remember. Like, I remember Rex could die potentially, or I don't remember the context of it. Which, if he's dead in Mass Effect 1, what happens in Mass Effect 2? Because you see Rex. He's the leader of the Krogan. Woo! If he dies, his number two is the leader instead. Oh, okay. Got him. I've come to take over your ship. I've also come to hit the F5 button, but it's not working. Okay, this Spectre Sniper Rifle is still pretty good, even on Insane.
On me!
Skadoosh! Shoot him on the ground! Shoot him on the ground! Woo! F5. F5? F5? F5 just does not work. F5. Because are they really in the... Yep, buddy.
Lost shields.
Noticed. You got a Rex in me.
Shields down.
Look at that. We're not dead.
That's it. Bag him and tag him.
Good job, guys. Good job. Really, I'm genuinely a little surprised.
Nothing between us and the Solarian camp now.
He sounds so excited. Can you tell the excitement in that Krogan's voice? Palpable, chat. Palpable. All right, Shepard. Let's go down and take a look. I don't think we're close to beating this game. At least it doesn't feel like we are. But if for whatever reason this week we do get to it, I do want to dip just a little bit into Mass Effect 2. Partly because I want to see how well the character models transfer over. And when you start off as like a total asshole,
Normandy's touched down at the base, but
what does that
like
start with?
Grounded.
How
Solarian
does that start?
Captain can explain when you get here.
Also, I wonder, do we have to redo Renegade points? Because, you know, colossal asshole here.
There's the
save it. There we go. Just in case.
So what are we supposed to do now?
Stay put until we can come up with a plan.
Status.
Are you in charge here? What's the situation?
I'm Captain Kirahi, 3rd Infiltration Regiment STG. You and your crew have just landed in the middle of a hot zone. Every AA gun within 10 miles has been alerted to your presence.
You kidding?
Oh, that's just great. What now?
We stay put until the council sends the reinforcements we request.
We are the reinforcements.
What? You're all they sent? I told the council to send a fleet.
I'm all you need.
We couldn't understand your transmission. They sent me to investigate.
That is a repetition of our task. I lost half my men investigating this place.
So what have you found?
Saren's base of operations. He set up a research facility here, but it's crawling with Geth and very well fortified.
Is he here? Have you seen him?
No, but his Geth are everywhere and we've intercepted some comms referring to Saren. This is his facility, there's no doubt about that.
What's Saren researching?
He's using the facility to breed an army of Krogan.
How is that possible?
Apparently, Saren has discovered a cure for the genophage.
What's so important about curing this genophage?
It was the solution to the Krogan problem.
We introduced the genophage to the Krogan population after the uprising, to quell their numbers. Without it, the Krogan will quickly overrun the galaxy. And these Krogan follow Saren.
The Geth are bad enough, but a Krogan army. He'd be almost unstoppable.
Exactly my thoughts. We must ensure that this facility and its secrets are destroyed.
Destroyed? I don't think so. Our people are dying. This cure can save them.
If that cure leaves this planet, the Krogan will become unstoppable. We can't make the same mistake again.
We are not a mistake.
Is he going to be a problem? We already have enough angry Krogan to deal with.
Your problem.
Don't worry about it, Captain.
I do worry. That's why I'm still alive. Why don't you go talk to the Krogan? My men and I need some time to come up with a new plan of attack. In the meantime, if you need any supplies, you can talk to Commander Rentola. He's in one of the tents nearby.
For a price, right? Is that...
Looks like things are a bit of a mess.
Yeah. I wouldn't be so worried if it wasn't for Rex. He looks like he's gonna blow a gasket.
You think I should go talk to him?
Yes.
It wouldn't hurt. Well, it might, actually. Just do it carefully.
Rex doesn't worry me. He'll fall in line.
Really?
If you say so. But I'm gonna keep my eye on him, if it's all the same to you.
How about you? I don't think he's gonna fall in line, but... Kinda... Depends. Is that him just shooting off?
The upcoming battle frightens me, but I know Saren must be stopped.
Greetings, human. I am Commander Rentola. I can provide you with supplies for the upcoming mission. For anything else, I suggest you speak with Captain Kirahi.
Let me see what you have.
What little there is.
For a price. Yeah, for a price. Right. We'll buy that. Oh, junk? Do I even have any junk? Actually, now that I think about it, not like I can set that to junk. What junk are they referring to? Hey, Rex. Buddy. Having a moment, huh?
This isn't right, Shepard. If there's a cure for the genophage, we can't destroy it.
This has to be done. Saren is the enemy, not me.
Really? Saren created a cure for my people. You want to destroy it. Help me out here, Shepard. The lines between friend and foe are getting a little blurry from where I stand.
I don't think it's...
I don't care what your personal feelings are. This base gets destroyed.
Don't push me, Shepard. I followed you because I wanted to fight for something more than credits. If you can't give me a better reason than this to destroy the hopes of my people, then I'm done with you.
All you need to know is that I'm giving you an order to fall in line.
So that's it. All this time, and that's all I get from you. How can you not see what this means to the Krogan? This base can't be destroyed. I
will. Yes!
Saren doesn't care about these Krogan. They're tools.
I made me nervous.
He'll destroy them as soon as they're no longer useful to him. Is that what you want for your people?
No. We were tools for the Council once. To thank us for wiping out the Rachni, they neutered us all. I doubt Saren will be as generous. All right, Shepard. You've made your point. I don't like this, but I trust you enough to follow your lead. Just one thing. When we find Saren, I want his head.
Okay. Real quick. Okay. Looking at it now. That was done so well. Because even... Think about the limited facial animations they have here. You can still see, like, his eyes moving. His just tweaks here and there. Is you could see the characters thinking it through, right? But what's great about this is they didn't automatically give you that renegade or paragon option. They escalated the tension and then flipped and said, okay, now you can try something, right? You could talk him through it, but if you were going to be an ass right out the gate and go hard on him, there's an option. But boy, did it feel like for a second, like, oh, maybe they're not going to give it to me. Maybe I don't have enough, right? But then even the interaction, the dialogue, the reasoning, the logic, it's all good. It's all great. Ah, okay. Sorry.
Your ability to calm the Krogan is impressive.
Aww, communications relay. Skill too low. Damn. All right. Go take a look at Saturn.
Thank you for speaking with the Krogan. The assault on Saren's base will be difficult enough as it is.
You got a plan?
I assume that means you've come up with a plan.
Of sorts. We can convert our ship's drive system into a 20 kiloton ordnance. Crude, but effective.
Nice. Drop that nuke from orbit, and Saren can kiss his Turian ass goodbye.
Unfortunately, the facility is too well fortified for that. We'll need to place the bomb at a precise location.
Where do we take the nuke, and how do we get there?
The bomb must be taken to the far side of the facility. Your ship can drop it off, but we'll need to infiltrate the base, disable the AA guns, and pacify any ground forces first.
You want us to go in on foot?
I like it. Men.
Good. I prefer a straight fight anyway.
Give me two good fighters, I'll go in just fine.
We just don't have the numbers to meet them head on. I'm going to divide my men into three teams and hit the front of the facility. While we've got their attention, you can sneak your shadow team in the back.
I just hope you survive long enough to be useful.
We're tougher than we look, Commander. But it's true. I don't expect many of us will make it out alive.
Uh-oh.
And that makes what I'm going to ask even more difficult. I need one of your men to accompany me. To help coordinate the teams.
Get
it.
I don't
make a habit of placing my people under someone else's command.
I understand, but this mission is too important for personal preferences to get in the way.
He's right, Commander. We can't do this without both teams at their best. I volunteer.
Of course you do, Caden.
Not so fast, LT. Commander Shepard will need you to arm the nuke. I'll go with the Salarians.
With all due respect, Gunnery Chief, it's not your place to decide.
With all due respect.
Why is it that whenever someone says,
my choice,
with all due respect, they really mean kiss my ass?
Who would be better suited to the mission?
Either of these two will do, Commander. Both seem willing to sacrifice their lives if necessary, though if we are lucky, such sacrifices won't be required.
Williams, you'll accompany the captain. No heroics, understood?
Aye, aye, Commander.
I will have the ordnance loaded onto the Normandy and brief your crew.
She's right, with all due respect.
Sequencing.
Yeah, it's basically kiss my ass.
Do you have any questions before we go, Commander?
I want to know more about the bomb. How reliable is it going to be?
Not very.
Its reliability depends on the person arming it, but it will do the job. The drive system is highly impervious to damage from external sources. Once it has been armed, very little can stop it. The key is getting it into place and armed before the Geth can stop us.
Give me a quick rundown of the plan again.
You are Team Shadow. We will create... Disable the AA gun. Once you have the bomb, place it next to the geothermal taps. Then get out before it detonates.
Shadow seems clear enough. What would the other teams be called?
Eight and Switch.
Eigor, Manavai, and Jaeto. They were the initial settlements on our first three colony worlds. They are at the heart of Salarian territory to this day. These names will remind my men what they are fighting for. They must have a personal stake in the fight if we are to have any chance of success.
The Normandy's picking me up. How will your teams escape the blast?
We will engage the Geth as long as possible. Once the bomb is in place, we will fall back to try and escape the blast radius. If we move quickly, we should be able to escape with acceptable casualties. If not, then our memories will live on as martyrs to a greater cause.
You talk like this is a suicide mission.
I won't lie to you, Commander. There is a chance none of us will survive this assault, even your team. But we do what is necessary.
Let's do this.
Excellent. Then if you'll excuse me, I need to prepare my men.
Makes me wonder.
Well, this is it.
Did we have Caden or Ashley die in this?
Don't do anything stupid while I'm gone, LT. You too, Commander.
We'll be fine. You'll see.
Yeah, I just... Good luck.
Is there something you want to say, Chief?
I don't know. It's just weird. Going under someone else's command. I've got used to working with you. All of you.
Don't worry. We'll see you on the other side.
I know. It's been an honor serving with you, Commander.
You know, it's really weird, Ashley, that you would actually talk to me like that since the vast majority has been like, kiss my ass. I guess, you know, her attitude of being like, kiss my ass, let's kick some ass.
Whatever happens, everyone just keep shooting. We go in hard, hit them harder, and we'll be the only damn thing that comes out the other side.
That is...
Bet, Commander.
An absolute terrible idea.
You all know the mission and what is at stake. I have come to trust each of you with my life, but I have also heard murmurs of discontent. I share your concerns. We are trained for espionage. We would be legends, but the records are sealed. Glorying in battle is not our way. Think of our heroes.